Hello, this is Mike with Play More Games, and we're back for another episode of Saipan, the Bloody Rock. We are starting day two of the campaign game, so let's get into it. First thing we'll do is we'll roll for weather, and I've got the weather table pulled up right here. So we get clear weather, sunny skies. All right, that's good. That avoids any negative modifiers for rain or storm turns. So we check for fatigue. None of our divisions are at a point where it's going to impact their troop quality. Since this is the first turn of the day, now it's actually the 500 turn. I did say 700. It's the 500 turn. So the sake and the whiskey are both available to be used. So we'll go to spending dispatch points. So let's pop open the cup and we'll look at the Americans first. So they both have a healthy amount of dispatch points. The 4th Marine Division has 0 direct commands. They are at 1 and 2 fatigue points respectively. So there's quite a bit that needs doing. So let's pop both of those chits in to start. And then depending on how things go, the division chits I should mean, we might purchase a couple of regiment chits. But we'll see. So Japan, 47th, they will pass, because they want to get that big division chit, so they can activate all of these units, perhaps on the 0700 turn. The 43rd, however, it will buy their division chit, and let's see if there's a formation nearby that they would want to use. I know these are all division level units, which is unfortunate. Yeah, a lot of these formation level units are really just one or two infantry companies and a leader. Yeah, two infantry companies, two support weapons, one leader. So you're really not getting a lot of mileage out of that. So they'll save their points and see if anything comes up, so to speak. The Navy is maxed out, so they're gonna spend two to get their division shit. And yeah, that'll be good for that. All right, so getting more dispatch points, starting with the Americans. 2nd Marines, got them. They go up to 5. 4th Marines, got them. They also go up to 5. All right, Japan. 43rd. Got them. They go up to 6. 47th. I just get 1. Navy. They get 1 as well. Alright. So reinforcements. Reinforcements. So let's see what we got. It looks like I forgot to put these in the box, and since I bought those chits last night, they should be over here and available. So I will just move them there now. Okay. No reinforcements till the 0700 turn. Which is fine. Alright. So everything's in the cup. Alright, so let's get started. Navy. Brand new day on the island of Saipan. So let's start with some bombardments. That's a good hex. Basically, we're going to be aiming at their support weapons, their heavy weapons. Basically, anything that can really put some hurt on us. And we'll see if we can dish out some damage to this hex here. So, alright. So this hex will be -1, so 6 or fewer. No. But that does place a heavy barrage marker. Down here, it is 2. Excuse me. 5. So that's a 0, so that's a DG and a suppression. That will also place a heavy barrage. And then down here, this is a 5 or fewer. 3 is 2 DG and a route check. Alright, so route check. Ooh, it's not good. Alright, so route check, once again, as always. Case A does not apply because there's no star. We have a die roll of 8, subtract 1 for the terrain, 7. Plus 1 for the unit is 8. And troop quality is +1, which is not enough, so they're actually going to become pinned. And they are under a heavy barrage. Another fine morning in the United States Marines. Alright, Second Marine Division. Alright, so first things first. We are going to rally basically everything. I'll just move that so I remember that it's been moved. This is so I don't come back around later and then try to do it again. Some attacks here. This stack here is 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 against this stack here, which is 8, so 8 or fewer. One on the yellow is going to be DG R star. So I have to remove one of these. And one of these will take a route check. Five. Don't know that that will. Yeah, that'll pass. It's two for terrain, is three. And they do have the two for troop quality and one for their own quality. I'm going to add a pinned marker to the hex because that is a fail. And this stack here will attack there. It's I'll deploy one of these. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 12 minus 2 for terrain and 1 for the slope, I think. No. So anything but a 9. 2. 2 on the yellow is 2 DGR. RRR 5. Actually, I think that's going to be another route. Yeah. So 5 becomes a 3. Add the 3 back is a 6. Troop quality is a 5 minus 1 is 4. So that's a route, so actually that's going to route back to its divisional card. Not good. I suppose we can take the shot here. 4, 5, 6, 7. Deploy one of these for 8. So it's minus 3 for the pillbox, minus 2 for the town is 5. So 3 or less. It's a 9, that's a fail. And I believe since we rolled a 9 on an attack with the support weapon, I believe that the support weapon goes to the reallocating box. Yeah. This stack will take a this tank will take a free shot there. I need a 0. No. This stack here will attack here. So it's 5, 6, 7, 8 minus 2 plus 3 is 9. So anything but a 9. 0. It's nice. Two DGS. This stack will go One, two. Yeah. And we'll call it there. I think that's going to be everyone. Just out of range. That unit's fine. Order of the day is to stay and die, I think. This unit will try and move away, so that's going to draw opportunity fire. Fails. Thankfully. So it's 1, 2, 3, 4. They'll dig a trench or foxholes. Entrench effort here. 5, that's a pass. Entrench here. That's a pass. Now there is 1, 2 hexes that can opportunity fire if I try to move these away, so I them. One of these units will rally. One will build foxholes. And let me double check, but I don't think. Yeah. That doesn't draw opportunity fire. Alright. So this hex here is done. Let's see, foxholes. 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 1, 2, 3, 4. Do they have a bunch of direct commands? They do. Foxholes. 1, 2. Direct command for that. Direct command for this. Trench. Trench. Fail. Trench. They have the leader there, so that's a pass. Pretty sure how it works. Foxholes. Foxholes. This one move. Trenches. Basically, we're digging in everywhere. Oops. I've done that twice now. Great. Then we're gonna roll to bring on that reinforcement group. B. That's a pass. So where are you, B? There you are. Division is there, so we'll stick you there. So one will dig in, one will go 1, 2, 3, 4, and dig in there, and we'll give that one the leader. And this one. Oh, that's not actually a support weapon. My eyes betrayed me. I'll leave it right there for now. Okay. A lot of earthworks. Forgot to move this to day 2. Next, 4th Marines. So, let's try something out. Let's try the active units feature. Let's see how this works. Oh, great. Alright, so remove, and then how do I, actions completed. Alt backslash. I think I'll just stick to right-click commands, right-mouse-button commands. Nothing fancy or special for me. Decent amount of rallying. Alright, so this stack here will attack here. We're gonna try and see if we can finish them off. Alright, so it is 5, 6, 7, 8 minus 1 is 7, plus 1 is 9, minus 2 is 7. So 7 or fewer. So it's a 2 on the yellow, And what does that get us? 2 on the yellow is 2 DGR. Alright, so route check. It routes, but a suppressed unit that gets pinned ignores the pin. Alright, so this stack is actions completed. We'll go 1, 2, 3. Done. Excuse me. We are going to get some trucks out and move up these artillery units. And when we put on a truck, when we put a unit on a truck and we move it, so let's get our truck counters out. We love our trucks, don't we? So this stack here, 5, 6, 7, against this stack here, 7, no, this stack here, 4, 5, 6, against here, which is minus 3 or less, fewer, no. Stop there. 1, 2, 3, 4. One, two, three, four. Hold off on any sort of direct commands for now. Alright. It's a cool feature. Probably gonna have to start using it because of how big those divisions are getting. Alright, so amphibious movement. Pretty simple. We just have these guys hanging around in the transport zone. They are not due for another 2 turns. Wind. Air. Die roll. 3. Decent. That is actually only 2. It's all right. See if we can take out some weak units. Alright, So we'll do six here, straight six, and we'll pay for it now so we don't forget. All right, so six or fewer. Nope. And then here, six or fewer. Poof, got the big result. Four TGR. It's gonna eliminate everything in the hex. So the leader will go over here. Eliminated. Eliminated. All right, next chip. Imperial Navy. So the Navy. Trench. No. We'll do foxholes. Foxholes. They're in a pillbox. Trench. No, trench. I believe their troop quality is 3. Yeah. So that will flip. Trench. Trench, trench. Trench. Nope, they're in a cave. Cave. Foxholes. Seven. I believe this is the Japanese ammo dump misfire. Yeah. All right, so artillery. Let's try. We'll do this one. So six yellow. 2 yellow is 2 DG and a route check. I believe that's going to be a route. So we'll place that as pinned. American Direct Command. So 2nd Marine Division. They get 10. 4th Marine Division, they get 8. So let's go ahead and we'll continue to kind of refit. Oops. So that's 3. This 3 stack will target there. So that's 1 on the yellow. There's a DG. So one of these is eliminated. Route check failed. Pinned. another three direct commands. And then we'll target this hex here, this group of Americans. 5, 6, 7, 8. Let's roll it. Oh, that's a fail. Well, actually, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 minus 2 is 9. So anything but a 9, actually. So that is another elimination. So we'll give the 2nd Marines a break. And we'll look at the 4th Marines. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Spend all their command points down, but they are refitted, ready to tango. Alright, so Japanese direct command. Yeah. 43rd, 47th, Navy. Alright, so 43rd. They get 7. So they will go from 4 to 11. They only get 3. And the Navy gets 4. Rally that off. Rally that off. Guess we'll just be good with that. Go trench roll here. That's going to be a pass with the leader's help. Trench roll there. It's a pass. Let's do 1, 2, and 3. So north to south. Two passes. Three more. Alright. So let's attack here. With this unit. Most two, I should say. That's a 0 on the yellow, so that's a pass. They hit, which is 2 DG and a suppression. stack here, we'll attack there, needs a zero. No. You do have to remember, as the Japanese, to keep attacking, because if you don't, the Americans will just have their way with you. It took a lot of resources this turn. 4 dispatch points, 2 fatigue points, dozens, or like 15 to 20 direct commands to basically refit to this level, and there's still a bunch of disorganized markers out there. Not as many as there were before, certainly, but... And that was an entire turn where the Americans didn't advance very much. They just kind of picked off some Japanese units that were vulnerable. But I'll tell you, this is going to be tough going. These are good modifiers. -5. So, like I said before, you really got to bring that 10 stack to get really any chance of doing any good there. Okay. I think that was the last chit, was it not? It was. Alright, so let me just put the rest of these away. And we'll say, that Americans are definitely off to a great start in this campaign, I think. Truthfully, I'm starting to wonder how the Japanese are going to be able to pull this out. I think that a victory point or having more victory points seems unlikely than the Americans now, since they have a nice victory point cushion. And we'll end up with a couple more victory points. You never know. So I think maybe going for the attrition win, but there is a lot of turns, a lot of days to go. So hoping for some tropical storms at least once or twice during this campaign for sure. All right, so this is Mike with Play More Games, and thank you for watching. We'll catch you in the next video.